All right, in this video we're going to talk about some unit conversion problems. When you're converting from one unit to the other, which we're going to have to do a lot this semester, there is a method that works every single time, and so we're going to start building that method with some very simple problems. The first thing I want to talk about, the first thing I want to ask in doing a unit conversion problem is I want to ask you a very simple unit conversion problem. If I were to say convert 2 feet into inches, most of you could probably just do that in your head. You probably would come up with the answer. The answer is 24 inches. But what you're doing in your head is you're doing a stepwise method. You're doing the math in your head to convert from 2 feet into inches. And so what we want to do is we want to write out that method that you're using in your head so that we can work the more complicated problems. In order to convert 2 feet into inches, you have to know what's called an equivalence. You have to know what makes feet and inches equal to each other. And most of us learn early in life that 1 foot equals 12 inches. That is the conversion between feet and inches. That's an equivalence. So to convert from 2 feet into inches, you're really wanting to know how many inches equals 2 feet. So mathematically, you're looking at how many inches equals 2 feet. This is the beginning of our math equation. And the next thing that we have to do to convert from feet to inches is we have to multiply by a ratio. This ratio will convert our feet into inches. The ratio has a numerator and a denominator. There's a unit in the numerator and a unit in the denominator that makes this problem work. The unit in the denominator has to be feet, so that our unit of feet will cancel. The unit in the numerator will be inches, so that we'll be left over with inches. You'll notice that I put these units over to the right on this ratio symbol because we've still got to put some numbers in, but we don't put the numbers in first, we put the units in first. To put the numbers in, what I'm multiplying by is the ratio that makes inches and feet equal to each other. That maintains the measurement of 2 feet. It doesn't change the fact that it's 2 feet. It just converts it from feet to inches. And up here, there is 1 foot, so a 1 goes with the feet, for every 12 inches, and so a 12 goes with the inches. And you can either plug it into your calculator or work it in your head. The unit of feet cancels. Unit of foot cancels, and so 2 times 12, you can divide by 1 if you want to, but it keeps it'll give you the same answer, 24 inches. So my answer is 24 inches. Converting 2 feet into inches, I get 24 inches. I want to work a slightly more complicated problem now. I want to look at some metric prefixes that we worked with when we talked about our prefix table. So the next thing I want to do is I want to ask, how many meters is 24.8 centimeters? How many meters is 24.8 centimeters? Again, a very similar type of problem. It's a unit conversion problem, and to be able to work it out, we need to know an equivalence. Only this time, it's an equivalence between meters and centimeters, the two units that are in this problem. You probably have a prefix table handy. Maybe you've memorized some of these prefixes, but from the table, when I look up centi as a prefix, I'll see that it's 10 to the minus 2. And recall, when we talked about prefix tables, that means there are 10 to the minus 2 meters equal to 1 centimeters. The multiplier from the table goes with the base unit, which is meters, for every 1 of the prefix, which is centi. So 10 to the minus 2 meters equals 1 centimeter. So this problem becomes question mark meters equals 24.8 centimeters. We're starting the problem just like we did above with our inches and feet. The next thing we do is we write times and a ratio sign, and we put the unit of centimeters on bottom over to the right so that it will cancel. You always fill your units in first. Your units guide your problem. I'm going to put the unit of meters on top because that's what I want to be left with when I'm finished with this problem. And the numbers that go in this ratio are up here in my equivalence. There's a 10 to the minus 2 in front of the meters, and there's a 1 in front of the centimeters. My unit of centimeters cancels. I punch this in my calculator or work it in my head, and 24.8 centimeters times 10 to the minus 2 divided by 1 equals 0.248 meters. There's my answer in meters. All right, so there's a problem converting between centimeters and meters. Let's work one more in this next problem. Let me get it up here. We want to ask the question, how many micrograms are 3.8 grams? How many micrograms are 3.8 grams? Micro is a prefix. It's on a prefix table. My base unit is grams. If I look up micro, I see that it's 10 to the minus 6, and that means there are 10 to the minus 6th grams that are equal to 1 microgram. That's how I interpret that prefix table. 10 to the minus 6 grams equals 1 microgram. So my question is, question mark, micrograms equals 3.8 grams. That's the start of my problem. We're following exactly the same pattern that we followed in the first two problems. And then I use times and my ratio sign. My unit of grams will go down here so that it cancels. My units of micrograms will be on top, so that'll be left over with it. And the numbers that go here, after I finish putting my units, come from the equivalents. 10 to the minus 6 grams and 1 microgram. So the 1 is on top, the 10 to the minus 6 is on bottom. Just a note about the calculator use before we solve this. 10 to the minus 6th is the same thing as 1 times 10 to the minus 6th. This may be easier to think about as you punch it into your calculator using your exponential notation, your scientific notation on your calculator. But one way or the other, you want to get that punched into your calculator. Your unit of grams will cancel and you'll be left with units of micrograms. So you punch in 3.8, you can punch times 1, divided by 10 to the minus 6th, or 1 EE negative 6 on your calculator. And your calculator will give you the answer. It may display it in scientific notation, in which case it'll display 3.8 times 10 to the 6th micrograms, or it may display it so that it's not in scientific notation. It just depends on the settings on your calculator. So it may give you 3800000, and that would be the answer in micrograms. Just a quick review about scientific notation. These two numbers are the same. This 10 to the 6th means my decimal has moved 6 places from here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There's my 3.8 times 10 to the 6th. As an answer to a homework or a test question, you can write it either way, unless the instructions specify you should write it either in scientific notation or in plain decimal notation.